To our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Sarah. Now will I praise those godly men, our ancestors, each in his own time. These were godly men whose virtues have not been forgotten. Their wealth remains in their families, their heritage with their descendants. Through God's covenant with them, their family endures, their posterity for their sake. And for all time, their progeny will endure. Their glory will never be blotted out. Their bodies are peacefully laid away, but their names live on and on. At gatherings, their wisdom is retold, and the assembly proclaims their praise. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
God will give him the throne of David, his father.
God will give him the throne of David, his father.
The Lord swore to David a firm promise from which he will not withdraw. Your own offspring I will set upon your throne.
God will give him the throne of David, his father.
For the Lord has chosen Zion. He prefers her for his dwelling. Zion is my resting place forever. In her will I dwell, for I prefer her.
God will give him his throne to David, his father.
In her will I make a horn to sprout forth for David. I will place a lamp for my anointed. His enemies I will clothe with shame, but upon him my crown shall shine.
God will give him his throne to David, his father. Alleluia!
Prophets and righteous people long to see what you see, but do not see it, and to hear what you hear, but do not hear it. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
How fortunate you and I are to hear, to experience, and to, of course, live the mystery in which God has called each of us to. That's an important vocation, don't you think? To know, to follow, and to live. It's discipleship. And discipleship has a cost. And that cost is that the gospel is countercultural. There's going to be times in our own life that it will be difficult to live the gospel message, to speak the truth, and to make sure that this message of truth is, of course, present in our own life, you know, by what we do and what we say, the conversations that we have, not to be silent, but to understand completely that God's grace is powerful than anything that we can do. I hope we're all convinced of that, that God's grace is more powerful than we could ever imagine. So to trust in his plan for you and me, and to rely on that grace. That's what Joachim and Anne did. They relied on the grace of God to bear a child, even at their old age, their only daughter. See, in God's time and his plan, he allowed this to happen. He allowed them to be the parents of the very mother of the incarnate Word of God. And And of course, they did not know that, just like you and I don't know things that God has in store for us. But Jonah come and surrendered and trust. Isn't surrender and trust difficult at times? You know why? Because we don't have a crystal ball, do we? We don't know what's going to happen tomorrow, or in a year from now, or in 2 years. But we trust in His grace. We look at our own life and some of the problems that we endure and the anxieties that we have, the troubles that we think about, and they can overwhelm us and cause us to be paralyzed. We all have been there. But what is it with trust? What is it with acceptance to God's will for us? How do we attain it? That complete surrender, that sushi peg, which we talk about often, is that we rely on God's grace and we're convinced that that grace carries us through. If you could imagine, grace, of course, is God's divine life in us, but it's the powerful wind of the Spirit that keeps us going and pushes us through and puts us in the direction that we ought to go. So our prayer has to be that we surrender to whatever God wants of us. Sometimes that's hard, isn't it? I surrender to you, God, whatever you want of me. Can we let go and let God do it? Do His work, that is, using us. We see it in the lives of so many people in Scripture. But God calls us to that same kind of vocation. This beautiful woman, the mother of Jesus, the mother of the incarnate Word of God, had beautiful parents that trusted in God. And in their age, their older life, they, of course, bore this door for the salvation of all in God's plan. And as Mary was conceived in the womb of Anne, she was without sin, the Immaculate Conception. That's right, that's where that title is from. Mary was conceived without original sin in the womb of her mother, Anne. And Mary was born as the mother of all the living. She's the new Eve, isn't she? She is the obedient one. She is the one who brought forth the Savior in our own trust and humility. May we pray for all parents today and grandparents. Joachim and Anne are the grandparents of Jesus and also the parents of the Blessed Virgin Mary. That role of parenting is so important today, especially as we parent and mentor children and grandchildren in the ways of God, that we take the time to teach them about God, about the truth of the gospel, about prayer, about surrender. But not only teaching them, but giving them the best lesson of all, the example of our life. May Saints Joachim and Anne truly inspire us to lead others into a complete surrender and trust to God. Because God has a plan for everything. May we cooperate with that plan.
After reflecting on God's holy word, let us now place these petitions before the Lord with confidence and trust.
For all members of the church, may God grant us fortitude in facing the daily challenges that come with being a disciple of Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those in civil authority, may the grace of God guide them in their leadership roles. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are sick, may the Lord pour out his mercy on their hearts and give them hope. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all present, may we grow in faith, hope, and love through the grace of our baptism and these sacred mysteries. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died marked with the sign of faith, may they come to know refreshment, rest, and peace in the Lord. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick and suffering, Dakota Hines, Barbara Wynn, Thomas Weiss, Therese Yannon, and all those on our prayer list, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for the intentions of Riley Gosnewski, for which this Mass is being offered, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. We also pray for the spiritual and temporal needs of St. Mary's Parish, so that all of us may further the mission of Jesus. Like St. Joachim and Anne, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us also pray for an increase in vocations to the priesthood and consecrated life, especially from members of our own parish family. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Good and gracious God, we place these petitions before you. If they're in accord with your holy will, we ask you to grant them through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, the for your goodness we have received, the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands, will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed
are you, Lord God of all creation, the for your goodness we have received, the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Grace to the brothers, my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and the glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Receive, we pray, O Lord, these offerings of our homage, and grant that we may learn to share the same blessing which you promised to Abraham and his descendants. Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up our hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for you are praised in the company of your saints, and in crowning your merits you crown your own gifts. By the way of life, you offer us an example. By communion with them, you give us companionship. By their intercession, sure support. So that, encouraged by so great a cloud of witnesses, we may run as victors in the race before us, and win with them the imperishable crown of glory through Christ our Lord. And so with the angels and archangels, and with the great multitude of the saints, we sing the hymn of your praise as without end we acclaim. bread and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Nelson, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and of all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil." Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await for the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world,
have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world,
have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
they receive blessings from the Lord and mercy from God their Savior.
Thank you. us who have recourse to you.
O Mary, conceived without sin.
Pray for us who have recourse to you.
O Mary, conceived without sin.
Pray for us who have recourse to you.
O Lord Jesus Christ,
who hath now saved and glorified by your numerous miracles, the Blessed Virgin Mary, immaculate from the first moment of her conception, grant that all who devoutly implore protection on earth may eternally enjoy your presence in heaven, who with the Father and Holy Spirit live and reign in God forever.
protection.